It's news time. Information is power. Be current. The news headline. Some cabals have taken over Nigeria. Governor Otom raises alarm. The Benue State Governor, Samuel Otom, has claimed that some persons at the federal level have taken over the rulership of the country, accusing them of bringing the nation to current state. The governor, after having some meeting with the President Muhammadu Buhari in some time ago, says that he had get to discover that his intentions have been hijacked by some cabal, seeing that he knows that Mr. President, as of 2015 when he got elected, has good intentions for our country, but as soon as he emerged, some cabals had actually swayed his heart from his good intentions and have taken advantage of several other things concerning the president. Says that he is even doubting if Mr. President is aware of what is happening, and if he was, he believes that he would have risen up to his responsibilities and take steps to correct what is actually happening, saying that many people have been intimidated not to talk as usual, and for as many people that have been patriotic as Nigerians to take up the situations going on in the country, that he wears everything, he sees that these people are actually intimidated, those that are even nursing the effrontery to address the situations in the country, as per how the nation is pushing the people into depression by its mayhem and several kinds of atrocities like kidnapping, abducting and the likes, which is bedeviling the entire nation economic and security situation. Also, there has been a steady rise in the prices of foodstuff in Nigeria in the past month, and the minister stated this Monday during the familiarization tour of the Agricultural Research Council of Nigeria, ARCN, in Abuja. "We are doing everything possible to bring up some kind of stimulus that will cause a reduction in food prices. Naturally, nobody will just sit and watch. We are doing what we can to see that the agricultural sector is improved and the food that we expect from the teeming population of Nigeria is being produced. The same thing with the livestock. The government is doing everything possible. This president, Muhammadu Buhari, is very passionate about agriculture, about seeing the people have food every single day to eat without struggles on the table," the minister was quoted saying. The minister also said that the president specifically directed him to make sure that the research institutes in the country were being taken care of, adding that it is his priority to see improved capacity to conduct research so that crops can be improved upon. The minister reiterated that the government was set to introduce Growth Enhancement Scheme, GES, after the scheme was scrapped a few years ago, adding that it has found a way that would make it work better. "My own concern is to make sure that the input gets directly to the farmers, not being withheld by middlemen. We will do all it takes to make sure that the system that will be rolled out gets the input of the grassroots farmers," he said. This is the Minister of Agriculture reiterating that the federal government of Nigeria is doing our best to ensure that the agriculture sector of Nigeria is actually advancing, such that every persons, that is every citizens of Nigeria, would be glad because there is food every now and then, seeing that President Muhammadu Buhari is actually passionate about every single day about how Nigerians can eat without struggling for food on their tables, where the minister said that he would support the Agricultural Research Council and the research institutes in the country to ensure that they develop better crops that can yield more and resist disease and drought. Says that the president had even specifically directed him to make sure that the research institutes in the country were being well taken care of, adding that it was his priority to see improved capacity to conduct research so that crops can actually be improved upon.
A counter concentration. So, no approach in that respect is on table for consideration yet. So, we will cross the bridge when eventually we get to that. When perhaps a type of request is made, we will then consider it. On why the Mambila power project was still being held down, Malami said the remaining obstacle to the project has been removed. He said the arbitration commenced against Nigeria by Sunrise Power Transmission Company of Nigeria Limited has been discontinued. Well, for the Sunrise, perhaps one good information or perhaps the hope for celebration that I wish to present for our consideration is the fact that Sunrise has indeed withdrawn its pending arbitral proceedings in respect of which it was claiming against the interest of the federal government an amount in the region of around $1 billion. So, the information that calls for celebration is the fact that there is no pending impediment relating to Mambila project with the discontinuation of the Sunrise proceedings in Paris, the minister said. And this is the Attorney General of the Federation, Abubakar Malami, saying to the pressman that actually interviewed him that the federal government is not outlooking the, using political solution in solving the case at hand as per the self-determination agitators who had been arrested for quite a while now, that is Sunday Adeyemo Igbo of the Yoruba Nation sect that had been agitating for the freedom of the Yoruba Nation, that is the breakaway from Nigeria, and also Nnamdi Kanu of the indigenous people of Biafra, which is also a secession group who wants to break away from Nigeria. And therefore, the Attorney General of the Federation says that in this regard, that they are not saying that they do not want to make use of political solutions to solve this issue, but for the government to take this into consideration, then a group or some group or anybody has to propose such to the federal government, and then they will look into it and see where they can actually come in after weighing the proposal. We know that the leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, IPOB, Kanu, had actually been accused of engaging in activities that can destabilize the country, where he was in charged, 7 fresh count charges against him, which borders on terrorism and treasonable felony. And his trial by Justice B. Ita Inyako had yet again been adjourned to January 19, 2022, where Malami said that as well, as far as security situation is concerned, the governance would not open their eyes and allow people, to do things that would break the country into two or breach the peace of the nation, saying that crime is a crime. And whenever there is a criminal undertone associated with particular conduct, the government needs to take steps to ensure that the people are operating in a way that is justifiable. And whatever it is not, or whatever is breaching the peace of the land, those behind it has to be brought to book.
Thanks for listening.